Whether you're a casual passenger or avid rail fan, you can probably easily recognize this logo here. Or if you're old school, I'm pretty sure you can also identify this one here. If not, these are Amtrak's two primary logos used over the course of their existence. To complement these, there's Amtrak's paint schemes or liveries. Officially known as phases by the company, patriotic stripes have become synonymous with Amtrak, being painted on locomotives, rolling stock, and company infrastructure. But to understand how the company went from the pointless arrow to the travel mark, we're gonna have to go back in time. It's the year 1970. Coming out of the colorful, psychedelic 60s, design trends would begin to stray towards more toned down and simplistic color schemes. Reds, oranges, and yellows, or more earthly tones like greens, browns, and desaturated blues. Fonts were also moving away from the bloated, exaggerated letters to something a bit more calm like Futura, Cooper Black, and ITC Avant-Garde. There were, however, more abstract, timely fonts like Data 70 being associated with technology and sci-fi. Meanwhile, the United States passenger rail system is now a dying mode of transportation. Antiquated equipment and infrastructure only cemented the demise. With railroads canceling passenger service outright throughout the late 60s and into 1970, something had to be done to save passenger rail travel in the US. The United States government stepped in creating rail packs in 1970, which would allow railroads to hand over their passenger operations to rail packs and reduce their losses. The name was derived from the code name for railroad passengers used by telegraphers. Operations were slated to begin on May 1, 1971. However, just a little over a week before operations began on April 21st, Rail PAX was renamed to Amtrak for legal reasons, combining the words American and track. This idea was conceived by public relations company Lippin Cotton Margulies from New York City. Amtrak was seen as easier to pronounce, more memorable, and an easier to remember name. Next up was to design a logo. This became the pointless arrow, symbolizing motion with patriotic American colors. The color red also acts as a good eye catcher and signifies fast, efficient motion. The font Helvetica would be used to display Amtrak's name. The logo was chosen for its reversibility when switching around passenger cars and flexibility being placed horizontally or vertically on timetables and advertising material. Amtrak would look to apply this logo and their overall brand to stations and equipment over the course of the next few years, breathing new life into the old equipment and infrastructure Amtrak had inherited. The arrow would show up in stations and on signs, whether it be decaled or physical, and basically on anything that signified to be Amtrak. Along with this effort, Amtrak planned to overhaul passenger cars, giving them new matching interiors with a typical, yet Amtrak-driven 70s color palette. When it came to locomotives, things were a bit hasty at first. Penn Central No. 4316 and EAA was painted into a promotional scheme showcasing the new logo. It was displayed in New York City for the first day of operations, then proceeded to work trains like the Broadway Limited for several months, bearing the early livery. Other trains, meanwhile, basked in the Rainbow Era, with equipment from all sorts of railroads being used on Amtrak's trains. It wasn't until 1972 that Amtrak came up with their own proper image. Before that, Amtrak hired designer Bill Atkinson in late 1971 to design a new line of uniforms. During the Rainbow Era, equipment and uniforms were all different, and it was said that having one cohesive uniform design, employees would feel like they were more on the same team. Atkinson would also cleverly incorporate the arrow logo onto anything he could, from the uniforms themselves all the way down to the shirt cuffs. The new look was unveiled at New York's Penn Station in February 1972, bearing the modern yet American colors. Illustrator David Klein would be another notable designer for Amtrak, creating vintage-style posters with the pointless arrow proudly displayed. On the exterior, Amtrak's locomotives and equipment received a fresh look as well. This became Phase 1. Using Amtrak's own brand of blue and red, this contrasted with black and platinum mist. Variations of this livery depended on the type of locomotive or train set. The placement of red paint earned units the nickname Bloody Nose, too. Quite the fitting name given the beat down and battered condition of most American railroads at the time. The soon-to-be famous Amtrak stripes would also originate on the UAC Turbo Train and Turboliner train sets, a line of matching stripes going along the entire set. Passenger cars also received this treatment. While it worked well with the brand new Amfleet cars, inherited heritage cars didn't always work well with the arrow logo, with it often being cut off. Amtrak stuck with Phase 1 up until late 1974, when Phase 2 would be introduced with the E60 electric locomotive. Gone was the bloody nose, and instead a line of stripes were applied. The arrow would be removed too. Also new going into 1975 was the Superliner Railcar, a bi-level long-distance passenger car. These got the Phase 2 treatment with a specialized font going into service starting in 1978. The stripe pattern is 34 inches tall with 2-inch white stripes and 14-inch red and blue stripes. Amtrak advertising around this time was also finding an identity of its own. Railroad artists like Jill Reed would design calendars and timetables with a vintage style. Other ads would promote scenic views not offered by the airlines and uncongested travels compared to the highways. On television, Amtrak looked to promote that luxury passenger rail was back, just like the glory days of train travel. America is getting into training
the Amtrak way. America is getting into training. Metroliner service 13 times each workday between New York and Washington.
Amtrak even had their own branded playing cards and mugs available to passengers. All these new additions quickly led up to yet another livery, that being Phase 3 in 1976, making Phase 2 the shortest-lived scheme. Phase 3 has a 24-inch tall stripe band and basically was just a replacement of the Phase 2 stripe band. However, this simple change would mark a turning point for Amtrak. Phase 3 would initially be applied to the RTL Turboliner, LRC, and AEM-7, but quickly be applied to almost all of Amtrak's equipment. At first, Phase 3 had a longer blue stripe spanning to the bottom of the unit, but was instead shortened to a standard 8-inch stripe like the red and white one. This change was made for safety, graphic aid, and saving money. The livery markings and white stripe were highly reflective too, making it more visible at night and at crossings. Perhaps the most famous application of Phase 3 was on Amtrak's EMD F40PH locomotives, being the flagship poster boy unit for the railroad. In the 1990s, other variants of Phase 3 were drawn up for the Dash A and Genesis locomotives. To start, both locomotives used a darker shade of blue and red, along with unique stripe patterns. The Dash 8s would be nicknamed Pepsi cans, based on the look of the drink's cans of the early 90s. The Genesis variant would be designed by Cesar Vergara, who also designed the angular body of the unit. The 24-inch pattern would be copied onto passenger equipment, except Superliners using a 39-inch tall pattern using 13-inch stripes. Phase 3 would become synonymous with Amtrak and by far the most popular and longest-lasting livery the railroad would run with. If you saw these stripes, it was easily recognizable as Amtrak. If not, just add some Helvetica and you'd be set. Phase 3 would go so far as to being applied to the ailing SDP-40Fs, along with the old high levels as well. This scheme would last for decades, lasting into mainstream revenue service into the early 2000s, with some even lasting into the 2010s, up to the making of this video in 2020. However, Phase 3 officially began its decline back in 1993 with the introduction of Phase 4 for new Superliner 2 cars built to replace the remaining Santa Fe-dated high levels. The new phase would be applied to locomotives starting in 1997. Ditching the three-stripe pattern, Amtrak began using darker shades of blue, red, and dark gray. Using three white stripes, two red ones, and one large blue stripe, it was a bit of a departure from the original red, white, and blue tri-stripe scheme. On the Superliner 2 cars, the top white stripe was omitted. Early Genesis locomotives had a silver face, while later units had a dark gray face. Printed on the side of passenger cars was Amtrak and/or Superliner or Viewliner. Meanwhile, during this time, Amtrak was going through lots of rebranding based on service regions. There was the Amtrak Talgo and Amtrak California in 1994. Amtrak California's colors would use 298 navy, 166 orange, 2408 yellow, and black, along with using the California Department of Transportation logo. Matching passenger cars would also be included. A new scheme for Amtrak California's NPCUs would be created in 2013 too. Back to Amtrak Talgo, it eventually became Amtrak Cascades in 1998. The Cascades service used Cascades brands of colors known as Evergreen, Castilian Copper, Double Latte, and Nugget, reflecting the Pacific Northwest region scenery. A unique logo was created as well. Also in 1998 was the Amtrak Surfliner, bearing an ocean-themed scheme of Amtrak Deep Blue, Black, Platinum Mist, and White. These new brands were made to better designate and differentiate services between each other while giving them their own identity. On the other side of the country in 1995, Northeast Corridor Amfleet trains received a unique Northeast Direct Service wordmark on the cars and was used up until the early 2000s. These trains had renovated seats, carpeting, and upholstery. This brand also replaced the Revolutionary War-themed names of the trains. Around this time though, throughout 1999 and mid-2000, Amtrak had decided to retire the pointless arrow logo in order to revitalize and modernize Amtrak's appearance for the 21st century and the unveiling of the Acela Express high-speed train, which was America's first. This was in conjunction with Amtrak's completion of electrifying the Northeast Corridor up to Boston, Massachusetts in January 2000. The first step was creating a logo and paint scheme for the new Acela brand. Combining the words acceleration and excellence, Acela was born as a professional and high-end service. The logo became an abstraction of a sea turtle's fin using a four-color blue gradient. Its design was meant to invoke and represent stately and peaceful service. Multiple variations existed, including a horizontal and vertically stacked version. Color variations included the gradient, solid Amtrak blue, black, and white. To fit the new logo was a new paint scheme. Phase 4 was refined into Phase 5, using Amtrak blue instead of the Amtrak deep blue. It was first used on the HHP-8 locomotives as it initially received Acela branding. Moving into mid to late 2000, Amtrak's new system-wide logo and brand identity would be designed by Oppenheimer and Company Brand Consultants. The logo became this, known as the travel mark. Utilizing negative space, it creates two rails going around a curve into the horizon. The color used in Amtrak's new brand became known as Amtrak Blue and would serve as the basis for any and all future advertising and infrastructure displays. Two common variations of the logo would be created for flexibility of usage, those being the horizontal and vertical lockup. These would be printed in either Amtrak Blue, White, or Black. Amtrak's overall new identity became much more streamlined, modern, and looked towards the future, replacing many displays of the pointless era. After the Acela Express went into service on December 11, 2000, to huge fanfare, a new naming scheme was adopted. Three levels of Northeastern service would be provided. The Acela Express, the high-speed service, Acela Regional, the rename for Northeast Direct, Empire Service, and Keystone Corridor trains, and finally, Acela Commuter, frequently stopping rush hour service. Acela Regional trains had their own capstone-painted passenger cars color-coded for their service. Inspired by the Acela logo, blobs of blues and greens were used. Standard coach used predominantly light blue, business class a darker blue, and the cafe implemented green. These cars would become known as mobiles. This whole system created much confusion amongst passengers, so in 2003, the three levels of service system was dropped. The Acela Regional became the Regional, later Northeast Regional, and the Acela Commuter went back to being the Clocker. Only the Acela Express name remained. Amtrak's website would soon receive an overhaul as well and get the new branding treatment in late 2001. With the Northeast sorted, Amtrak had looked to its long-distance and intercity trains once more. Amtrak's Genesis units would receive Phase 5 paint throughout the early 2000s. At first, this version had a thick red and blue line on the lower body angle. The Amtrak logo was also featured alongside the cab door. This look, however, didn't last long in favor of a single, thinner red safety stripe, plus removing the small cab side logo. This version is sometimes called Phase 5B. In 2002, Amtrak came out with Phase 6, or 4B. Using the same dimensions as the Phase 4 stripe band, Phase 4B uses the lighter Amtrak blue and red colors. On passenger cars, the simple Amtrak word mark was changed to the logo, and on superliners and viewliners, their respective lettering was removed. Amtrak would transition essentially all of its equipment into Phase 5, 5B, and 4B and use it up to this day. However, in 2011, to celebrate Amtrak's 40th anniversary, Amtrak painted several P-42s into heritage schemes based on the previous phase liveries. Phase 3 would see a return to rails with Amtrak NPCU number 406 on the exhibit train too. Around 2012, Amtrak Amfleets running between Chicago and St. Louis would receive a unique little decal, this denoting the Illinois High-Speed Rail Program elevating speeds up to 110 miles an hour. In 2013, Amtrak revealed a new variant of Phase 3 known as Phase 3B. This scheme was used on the new Viewliner 2 cars and soon enough in 2016, applied to the P32 ACDMs used on the Empire service. The Empire service would get its own unique logo as well, with an Amtrak train in front of the Statue of Liberty and Niagara Falls, both of which are things you can see along the route. Several other Amtrak corridor routes have received their own logos as well, many of which feature a modern minimalist design, which harkens back to 1920s Art Deco and other mid-20th century modern art styles, an era where the railroad was a staple of transportation and it seemed like trains were their future with modern streamlined locomotive designs. Back to Phase 5 though, it would get a unique, updated, modern variant on the Siemens SC44 Charger locomotive introduced in 2016. Amtrak's other branded services would get similar treatment. Since then, Amtrak has yet to unveil a new livery phase. Or do they? In early August 2020, Amtrak unveiled a brand new variation of the Phase 6 livery. Amtrak has plans to paint it onto five future ALC-42 long-distance charger locomotives. It harkens back to the 1971 Pointless Arrow logo in its design, with a large red arrow on the rear. A sixth unit will be painted to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Amtrak as well, though a paint scheme for the rest of the fleet has yet to be revealed. Also around this time, new passenger cars for the Illinois Department of Transportation were unveiled, using a new paint scheme to match the Siemens Charger locomotives. The Northeast Corridor hasn't been left out either, as the new Avalia Liberty train sets have their own unique livery. It's a bright, sharp, and modern combination of white, blue, and red with a sizable Acela logo decaled on the power cars. Small triangles give off an effect of high-speed motion as they fade away, similar to the SC44 Charger's circle pattern effect. Amtrak's design trends seem to be looking towards the future, with that future being full of speedy trains. Amtrak has had its fair share of logos and paint schemes over the past nearly 50 years. From the bloody-nosed, battered, pointless arrow era that was Phase 1, to the streamlined, modern, travel-mark ocean wave era of Phase 5. Apart from bog-standard maintenance colors of orange and silver, Amtrak's designs have been nothing short of unique and have consistently been updated to match current design trends that move with the times. From the reds and browns of the 70s to the blues and grays of the 2020s, the railroad has found itself in a whirl of colors. To this day, though, you can still find many traces of Amtrak's 1970s heritage, given many Pointless Arrow logos remain printed on station signs or physically made into 3D displays. Amtrak has truly mastered what it means to make an iconic logo and brand. Even in grayscale, or lacking any kind of text or displayed as a silhouette, every logo was still instantly recognizable. Amtrak hopefully has many more years of service to come, and along with it, many more years of iconic iconography.